It's Real Talk with Dr. David Anderson. How you doing today? You ready to talk to me? It's Wisdom Wednesday. Give me a call. Come on, let's go.
Live from our nation's capital, welcome to Real Talk with Dr. David Anderson. An expert on race, religion, and relationships, Dr. Anderson wants to talk to you. Our phone lines are now open. 888-432-7434. And now, please welcome Dr. David Anderson, your bridge-building voice in the nation's capital.
That's me, your bridge-building voice right here in the nation's capital. How in the world are you today? It's Wisdom Wednesday on my show, and we always ask God to give us wisdom, and guess what? He does just that. Well, you know, whether you're in D.C., Maryland, Virginia, parts of West Virginia or Pennsylvania, thanks for tuning in on WAVA 105.1 FM right here out of Arlington, Virginia. Of course, for those of you who are on my Facebook Live and YouTube Live page, I'm waving at you. Thanks a lot for being fans, followers, and friends. And my phone number, if you want to give me a call, it is a call and talk show. My number is 888. That makes it toll free. Do we still need those nowadays? But anyway, 888-432-7434. 888-432-7434. If you're trying to memorize the number, remember the word bridge. 888-43-BRIDGE. Today is Wisdom Wednesday. We start the week off with Marriage Monday, then Tough Topic Tuesday. Today, Wisdom Wednesday. Tomorrow, Theological Thursday. Open phone in Fridays. You can talk to me about anything you want. But today's topic is the wisdom of, are you ready? The purge. The wisdom of the purge. What or who do you need to purge from your life? What or who do you need to purge from your life? What's holding you back that needs to go? Well, this is why we need wisdom, not only the what and the who, but then the how. Lord, would you give us wisdom to know how to do it? And so I want to talk to you about it. I want to hear from you on the topic. And if this just scratched an itch that you had, you've been dealing with this, thinking about this, and now you're saying, you know what, I think God wants me to cut this out of my life, or this person needs to be purged from my orbit, so to speak. Well, I want to know who. And I want to know how you think about doing it, why. Maybe I can help you through it, walk you through it, talk you through it, pray you through it, as I often say. Let's bow for a word of prayer and ask God to be with us. Heavenly Father, we thank you that you are the giver of all wisdom, and we trust that you will provide for us just what we need in order to make the right decisions and to do it the right way. So we commit the show over to you now. In the name of Jesus, together everyone said, amen and amen. There are a couple other ways you can get a hold of me. You can always go to andersonspeaks.com, andersonspeaks.com, and there you can catch all the articles and sponsors and things of that sort that I have on that website. Or you can go to my favorite website, which I appreciate, embracegracism.com, embracegracism.com. Gracism, just put the G in front of the word racism, and you've got the new word gracism, which is the art of inclusion and really God's solution to racism. We also have up there the Gracism Creed, where you can sign the creed for racial healing if you want to help be a part of the solution, not a part of the problem. That's embracegracism.com. My phone number once again is 888-43-BRIDGE. 888-43-BRIDGE. Lastly, before I go to my phone lines, I just want to tell you, if you're in the Maryland area and you're looking for an amazing and very highly motivated, sharp, and professional real estate agent, then Maria Weaver is the lady you need to call. You can call her and she will sell your home, or she will make sure your home gets purchased. Guarantee you that. I've seen her in action many times, and she's amazing. That's Maria Weaver. She also speaks Spanish, and so you want to get her while you can. Let me give you her phone number, 443-656-0687. Her number again is 443-656-0687. We're talking about purging from your life. What do you need to purge? Who do you need to purge? And then we're going to ask God for wisdom on how to do it. All right, let's kick the show off with Carlos. He's in Fairfax, Virginia. Hello, Carlos. How are you, sir?
Good, thank you.
Thanks for calling. What is your comment or question, please?
Yeah, my comment is about the what I need to put from my life. I think it's myself. Whatever I know, whatever I raising, whatever I culture have, whatever I see the things in the life, how I see myself in my knowledge, in my wisdom, in the earth experience. I think the best thing for understand the word God is the part myself, be God coming and fill it up, His spirit in my, that's why I can get the wisdom of the word of God.
I see. So you want to purge your flesh and the natural thinking that you have and renew your mind with new thinking and the word of God and the power of God's Holy Spirit. Is that what I'm hearing?
Yes, glad so.
I understand. Is there anything in your flesh or in your natural man that you know needs to be purged specifically?
Yeah, my feelings. Sometimes my feelings is very strong.
Okay.
What I see the justice, what I see is good or bad. My feelings is very strong. I thinking if I be control that one, I can see what the God want from me.
Oh, that's wonderful. And the feelings that you have most of all are what? Is it anger or is it sadness? What's the predominant feeling?
That's what I'm saying. The way I see the things, the justice, myself.
Must be anger
sometimes
then.
Sometimes they make me angry. Sometimes they may be confused. Sometimes they make me. That's why I think I have to leave that everything and get it what the wisdom of God have for me.
Yes, it makes total sense. And I appreciate you sharing that with us. And we pray that God would give you His Holy Spirit and the fruit of the Spirit. So when you do feel that anger or that bitterness or that frustration, and I feel it too at times, the Holy Spirit just kind of ministers to you and makes you more self-controlled and more loving. So that's a great thought and a great prayer. Okay, Mr. Carlos?
Thank you, Mr. Anderson. God bless you.
And bless you back, my friend. I appreciate you. Listen, I'm going to run to my commercial break. As soon as I get back, I'm going to Baltimore, Maryland, to talk to Martina. I want to talk to you as well. Why don't you give a call right now? Tell my call screener who you are, where you're from, or tell her you're anonymous if you want. Give me the city, and as soon as I get back, I'm going to talk to you about the wisdom of the purge. Is there someone or something you need to purge from your life? We'll be right back. Hi, Jewel. This is Dr.
Hi.
Anderson. How are you?
Hi, Dr. Anderson, and hello to your guests. First, I want to thank you for Best Buy waterproofing.
Okay.
They are outstanding. Yeah, and I'm scheduled to get my work done in a week, but I just want to thank you. The free home inspection, they came out.
Love it.
It was just absolutely amazing.
They have over 30 years of experience, and they'll even donate $500 to my show if you end up doing business with them. But most of all, get your basement fixed. Give them a call, 844-980-3707. That's 844-980-3707.
Talk with Dr. David Anderson is not just an insightful radio talk show, but also a conversation that encourages listeners to engage in higher levels of understanding. Here's what people are saying about the show.
Dr. Anderson, I've been listening to you for a couple years now, and I just wanted to call in and say amen and hallelujah. You are on the mark.
I listen to you very much, and it's good. It's very, very good to hear your refreshing voice on your radio. You're not afraid to take any topic. You are very humble, and it just gives us comfort.
I love the radio station. My favorite is Marriage Mondays. Even though I'm not married, it's okay. I love it. I love the advice.
I listen to it all the time. I have my notifications on. I was on the show once upon a time. So I just love the advice and just the biblical sound and just stuff that he says on here. So it's amazing to listen to.
He's such an inspiration because not only does he impact the local area, but his message is so powerful that it deserves to go on a broader spectrum.
Comprehension begins with conversation. It's not just a phrase, it's a reality. Join the conversation at Real Talk with Dr. David Anderson.
Welcome back to Real Talk with Dr. David Anderson. For more information about this program or for resources from Dr. Anderson, please visit andersonspeaks.com. To watch on Facebook Live or to view past episodes, visit Dr. Anderson's public figure Facebook page. Just search Dr. David Anderson and click like. You can also watch live on YouTube. Just search for Anderson Speaks, all one word, and make sure to subscribe. Join our text community and receive a free weekly textpiration from Dr. Anderson. Just text the word INSPIRE to 97000. That's INSPIRE to 97000. And now, back to Real Talk with Dr. David Anderson.
That's me. I'm David Anderson, live in the nation's capital, hanging out with you here in the D.C. metropolitan area, and we are talking on this Wisdom Wednesday about the wisdom of the purge. What or who do you need to purge from your life? What's holding you back that needs to go? It's not always the easiest thing to do, and sometimes you got to identify it just right to make sure that you are doing the right thing, and this is why we need God's wisdom. Well, if you want to talk to me about that, if you want to have me walk you through it, talk you through it, pray you through it even, 888-432-7434. That is my number live in studio. Why don't you memorize it or do what a lot of people do? They just put my number in their contacts with my name, Dr. David Anderson, or Real Talk with Dr. David Anderson. That way, if you ever want to call me, I'm here every day, the first hour of rush hour out of the nation's capital. All right, let's go to Baltimore, Maryland, as I promised, to speak with Martina, who's on the line. Hello, Miss Martina. It's Dr. Anderson. How are you?
Hi, Dr. Anderson. I'm good. How are you?
Oh, I'm alive and grateful and so glad you're hanging with me. What are you thinking?
I have a situation where I don't know whether to purge a house of mine. It's a rental. It was my home, but my neighbors oppressed me so bad until I moved out and rented it out, and they're still vandalizing and bumping stuff in my yard, spray painting the house.
Oh, my.
Egging the house.
Sounds like it's more of a hassle than it is a help.
Exactly. So I don't know whether to purge it, get rid of it. Right now, I do have it on the market, but then there's a hold up from the sale. It's been the person that's supposed to be purchasing it. It's well over 2 months now.
Mm-hmm.
So the realtor says, oh, it's taking some time because they're doing, a lot of people are purchasing homes right now. But I didn't know whether that was a stall, just so that I could not sell it or.
Right. Well,
should I purchase?
I don't know the details of your situation, but two things. First of all, you've already made the decision to sell it clearly, which is probably good if you can get it out off of your books and get that headache off your head. Then that's a good thing, it sounds like to me. So that's one thing. But the second thing is when it comes to real estate, again, if you're going to be in Maryland, is your place in Maryland?
Yes.
Then I would definitely lean on Maria Weaver for her advice. She's good at this. She really is. I've seen her help a lot of people. She's a real estate agent that has advertised on my show before. Do you want me to give you her number so you can at least call her and ask her?
Sure.
All right. Do you have a pen?
Yes, I do.
And I'll say it out loud because somebody else might need her as well. Her number is 443-656-6555. 0687. Tell her Dr. Anderson told me on the radio to give you a call. Maybe you can give me some advice on this. And, you know, again, if you already have another agent, she'll just tell you whether what they're saying or not is true. Otherwise, if you can get her as your agent, you would be doing something because she's just great at that. Okay?
Okay. Sounds like a plan.
All right. Okay. Well, you might be purging this sooner than you think. I sure hope so, Miss Martina. Okay?
So you think with the oppression and everything, you think that maybe that might be what God wanted to do, get rid of the property?
Well, again, I don't know the property. I don't know your finances, but I do know that it sounds like it's a stressful thing in your life, and you don't want to be a landlord that's dealing with vandalism and trash thrown on your lawn. So, again, that's why we need wisdom. I know you need wisdom from God. I'm giving you really my limited opinion. I'm not going to say I'm speaking for God on this one. But it sounds like you've already made the decision. So what I would do is ask God, do you really want me to keep this? Because your heart wants to get rid of it. We haven't even talked. Go ahead. No, go ahead.
Well,
what were you going to say?
I really deep in my heart, I don't want to get rid of it. Okay, I drive the school bus.
Okay.
So I'm having some issues with the sleep apnea and everything. So I'm thinking that maybe I need to move away from the school bus, but I still have my rental property that I could move in because it's three apartments. I can move into it, but I have these neighbors that, you know, that just oppresses me and my sons. So, you know, I'm stuck between them. I don't know what to do.
I don't feel like, again, you just asked me my opinion on this one. You can ask the Lord for real wisdom on whether you stay or go, but it sounds to me like if he could deliver you from that, you'd be feeling a whole lot more peace. And if you want a rental property, go get another one. You know, if you want a place to live, go find one where the neighbors are nice. But it's terrible when people have bad neighbors. Like, you can have a nice house in a nice neighborhood and have nasty neighbors, and nasty neighbors can make a nice house not so nice anymore. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly. I understand.
You can be in an apartment, and the people in the apartment building, if they're cool, they're respectful, you're too loud, they ask you to turn it down. They're too loud, you ask them to turn it down, and everything is cool. That is great. That's good respect. But when you have people who are afraid to go in their own apartment buildings, and they're looking to see whose car is in the lot before they get out the car, I mean, that's no way to live if you have the power and the ability to get out of it. So that's my two cents, Martina.
Okay. That really gives me a good perspective on where I'm at. Okay, that's really, really good. Your two cents look like it's paid off.
Well, praise the Lord. That would be God's wisdom then. Hey, God bless you. We'll talk to you later, okay, Miss Martina?
Okay, thank you very highly.
Oh, yes. Blessings to you. Take care. 888-432-7434 is my number. It's also the word bridge, 888-43-BRIDGE. We're talking about the wisdom of the purge. What or who do you need to purge from your life? What's holding you back from going to that next level? Who needs to go or what needs to go? If you'd like to talk to me about it, maybe ask me a question about it, or I can just kick it with you to walk you through it, talk you through it, pray you through it, affirm what you're already doing, or say, you know what, have you thought about this? That's why I'm here, all right? I'm going to give you the number one more time. Then I'm going to Baltimore, Maryland, and talk to Donald. My phone number is 888-432-7434. All right, let's go to Donald. He's in Baltimore, Maryland. Hi, Donald. It's Dr. Anderson. How are you?
How are you, Dr. Anderson?
I'm alive and grateful. Thank you so much for calling. What are you thinking today, sir?
Well, first of all, thank you for your screener, because I told her, when I got on the phone, it seemed like I'm in school because I'm always learning something on this program.
Well, that's good. I'm glad. That's good news. Praise the Lord. Well, you can call and get as much information as you want. Thank you for listening. Tell your friends to listen too, okay?
Absolutely, man, because this one, I think I want to sit and listen. You bring up topics that I feel compelled to speak on.
Good, good. Well, how can I serve you today?
Well, actually, a prayer will help because I know what God called me for. You know, as a recovering, well, I won't even say recovered. God delivered me from from drugs and alcohol and all that addictive stuff along almost at least about 20 years.
Mm-hmm.
And I know that he's called me to minister to those that are still in bondage with that. You know, at times my thinking could be very addictive. And I just need the Lord to purge that out of me, because I know Jesus said that whom the Son set free is free indeed.
Mm-hmm.
And if I'm going to be set free from some, I want to be set free from all of it. So that way, when I do minister, I'm already doing that now. But I believe that the Lord is taking me to another, I guess the word you use is another level. You know, and my flesh is fighting it. My flesh is going crazy, man.
I bet.
And it's almost like withdrawals. So I'm just asking that God will help me with that, because I know He's taking some things out of me that need not be there, and my flesh ain't liking it.
Well, I'm sure your flesh isn't, and you know, with new levels comes new devils. And so as you're trying to go up to the next level, you're going to have some temptation, but that's okay, because Isaiah 43, verses 18 through 19, I'm going to read over you now, and you hold on to this as your word before I pray for you, okay?
Amen.
This is what it says. Forget the former things. Do not dwell on the past. See, I am doing a new thing. Now it springs up. Do you not perceive it? I am making a way in the wilderness and streams in the wasteland.
Amen.
So that's
Isaiah 53.
Isaiah 43, verse 18 and 19. That's a good word, isn't it?
Okay. Amen. Amen.
Let me read it one more time. Forget the former things. Do not dwell on the past. See, I am doing a new thing. Now it springs up. Do you not perceive it? I am making a way in the wilderness and streams in the wasteland.
That's hope, man. That's hope.
That's hope. No doubt about it. Let's pray. Lord Jesus, we lift up Donald from Baltimore, and Lord, we pray that he holds on to that hope that you are doing a new thing, that you told him he could forget the things of the past and not dwell on them, and that, Lord, now you're springing up a new thing. You're making a way in his wilderness, and you're placing streams, rivers, and water in the wasteland. Lord, we ask that you would give him the strength and the endurance, the perseverance, and the wisdom and the insight that's necessary in order to go to the next level. Go before him, but also, Lord, go behind him. So whatever comes from the back, Lord, you'll be his rear guard. And we thank you for that, Lord, that he will not fall and that his foot will not slip, but that he will walk by faith and not by sight and see the glory of the Lord among the land of the living. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen, my brother. You're covered. Go forth.
Amen. I like that insurance policy.
There it is. God bless you. That's Donald from Baltimore, Maryland. What about you? You need to purge something, let something go. You need to let someone go. You need to, you know, this is not for you married people now. I'm just saying, all right, we know. Talk about, I got to purge my husband. No, you don't. Hold on now. But what else? What else? Is there something else you need to? Well, give me a call. Let's talk about it. Maybe God is laying something on your heart. Maybe you just need some wisdom on how to do it. My phone number here in the studio is 888-432-7434. That number again is 888-432-7434. Now, I am going to go to my commercial break, and then when I get back, I'm going to take your phone call. So go ahead while you can and get in where you fit in. And if you're looking for a job, or if you're looking to hire employees, you want to make sure to go to conceptiqconsulting.com. That's conceptiqconsulting.com. Tell them Dr. Anderson sent you. We'll be right back. This is Real Talk with Dr. David Anderson. It's Wisdom Wednesday. The power of the purge. Wisdom of the purge. What or who do you need to purge from your life? What's holding you back that needs to go? You know, sometimes people bring sunshine into your life and it makes you really happy. It makes you smile. But sometimes there are people that may bring a little darkness into your life. And if the darkness passes, then, you know, it doesn't mean you need to purge them. If they take you through pain or you go through pain, it doesn't mean that you need to purge them. So we're not saying purge people because it's a difficult relationship. We're saying there's sometimes that there are people or there are things in your life that might be holding you back from going to the next level. And if that's the case, what or who is it? Well, if you want to give me a call to talk it through, feel free to do so now. My lines are open. My number is 888-432-7434. Now, Beth Spence says on my Facebook page that she and her husband split up in May because he was trying to choke her to death. He was in a mental institution. Now that he's out, she wants to know if she should keep checking on him. And if she doesn't, will God be upset with her and maybe not even accept her into heaven? Well, Beth, God's going to accept you into heaven based on your relationship with him. If you've invited Jesus Christ to come into your life and to forgive you for your sins, and you've chosen to follow him by faith, you are his child, and your heavenly home is secure. So let's make sure we have that down first. If you've not done that, I want you to pause and pray and invite Jesus to come into your life. I want you to ask him to forgive you for your sins, and I want you to ask him to make you new and to thank him that he died on the cross for you and rose again from the dead. That's the first thing, okay? Then you will be new in Christ. Now, if you've already done that, then you are secure and you have heaven for your home for the future no matter what. All right, so that's done. Now, about your husband. Unless you have a third party that can sit you guys down to bring reconciliation in the future, I would not meet with him, I would not call, and I would leave him alone. The man tried to choke you to death. The man went to a mental institution. Pray for him. That's the best thing that you can do for him. But if you keep calling him and keep sending him the signal that you're okay, then he's going to come back around the house and try to have another shot at it. What I mean by that is have another shot at your relationship, which is okay, except if he's mental and violent, then next time you may not be so quote unquote lucky. And so don't put yourself in physical danger by staying in the relationship. I'm not saying get a divorce. You're split up right now. If you're going to reconcile the relationship, make sure you have a third party. That can be a pastor. That can be a counselor. But outside of that, I wouldn't be spending much time with somebody trying to choke me out. All right? There's my 2 cents, okay? You ask God if it's wisdom or not, because I'm not the giver of wisdom. He is. So you ask him if that's wise or not. If he says it's not and you're supposed to do something different, do what he says, not what Dr. Anderson says, okay? 888-432-7434. Mark is in Washington, D.C., so I'm going to go there. Hi, Mark. It's Dr. Anderson here. How are you?
Hey, brother.
Hey, how are you?
Hey. I'm just thinking about something. I mean, hope nobody hear me on radio. Can they hear me on radio?
Yeah, everybody can hear you right now. You're live, so watch what you say. Go ahead and say it. Just make sure it's not profane.
Look, I gotta let go of the procrastination thing.
Okay.
I gotta purge my procrastination syndrome. I gotta come out of procrastinating. I gotta stop procrastinating.
What are you procrastinating for? I don't even know how to ask the question. Why are you procrastinating? And what is it?
I just like my will to get up and go do what I'm supposed to do when I say I'm gonna go do it stuff.
Anything specific or more like in general? You just are a procrastinator no matter what it is.
It's just more, so to speak, it's something specific like starting my own business, and it's general, I'm procrastinating, period.
Okay, gotcha. And why do you procrastinate?
I don't know, man. I just something in me. I set goals and then I stick to them up to a certain point, and then I stop. I set goals and stick to them up to a certain point, and then I stop.
Yeah. Well, you know the answer to procrastination, right? It's the what? it's the Nike slogan, just do it. So what's one thing that you need to do in the next 24 hours?
You know, write out my goals for next month and next year.
Uh-huh. Okay, so you need to write out your goals for the next month. All right, today is Wednesday. Can you do that and call me back on open phone in Friday and tell me what those goals are?
Yeah, I can. But can I ask you something?
Yes, sir.
Next time I call you, man, I would like more, a little bit more privacy. I don't want to be.
Sorry, man. You called a radio show. You called a radio show, man. So you call a radio show, you're going to get a radio talk show host, and it's going to be 300,000 people listening. So, but let's start with you write down those goals and then call me on Friday. I want to know that you did it. If you don't call me on Friday, that means you didn't do it.
All right.
Deal?
But look, if I call you, I want privacy, man. I don't want to be live.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, that's the way it works. That's why it's radio. Well, listen, here's the thing. Do it for yourself. Instead of even calling me, do it for yourself. Make that your deadline. Do it for yourself. You can even call me back and tell me that you did it without all sharing right. What those goals are.
All right.
Okay, you don't have to tell me exactly. If you don't want everybody else to hear, because it is a public radio show, and what you say is not, you know, private. So if you're like, hey, look, I'm going to stop, well, you know, whatever. Okay, I'm going to let you go on that one. I got to run to my commercial break, Mark. Thanks a lot. When I get back, I'm going to Silver Spring, Maryland. I'm going to talk to Lisa, who's on the line. And I want to talk to you as well. So get in right now because there's only like one more segment left, for real, for real. So 888-432-7434. That's 888-43-BRIDGE. And flash alert, this is public radio. I'll be right back.
Are you looking to hire quality people for your company? You need skilled, screened, and serious candidates who are ready to serve your mission and vision on day one, right? I know just the recruiting consulting firm that can help you. It's Concept IQ. Dr. Anderson has known the president, Mark Weissman, for years, and he will work with your company to get you the most qualified labor force you need, whether accounting, administrative, finance, IT, medical, retail, government contracting, or more. Mark will work with you to fit your company's needs. If you're looking for work or looking for good workers, contact Mr. Mark Weissman today at 877-472-9001. See how Concept IQ Consulting can help grow your business with the qualified talent you need. Again, call 877-472-9001 or check them out online at conceptiqconsulting.com.
Have you ever driven through your neighborhood and saw that neighbors had their grass that was way too long? They had all kinds of clovers in the grass, and you're wishing as you drive silently, I wish they would mow their lawn. Well, guess what? Why don't you get them a gift? Call Laser Landscaping and let them cut the lawn for your neighbors. Go to Laser with a Z Landscaping LLC on Facebook, or give them a call if you want them to beautify your lawn. 240-516-4967 for those who live in the Prince George's County and surrounding areas. Their number once again, 240-516-4967. It's Laser Landscaping, or just ask for the owner, Fidel, and make sure you tell Fidel that Dr. Anderson sent you.
Does your church have legal challenges? McCullum & Associates has experience with pastor-church relations, administration and organizational issues, church liability and risk management, and real estate matters. This firm understands the legal aspects of the problems, as well as the spiritual implications of those same problems inside and outside the court. Call McCullum & Associates today at 301-864-6070. That's 301-864-6070.
It's Real Talk with Dr. David Anderson. How in the world are you today? Listen, if you live in the Prince George's County area and you want some amazing lawn service, then make sure you check out Laser Landscaping LLC. You can see them on Facebook, Laser spelled with a Z, Laser Landscaping LLC. And tell Fidel that I sent you. You can call him if you want to. He'll come and not only make sure it's mowed and all the leaves are gone and make your yard beautiful, but he'll make sure to do it in a way that makes me proud as well, because I like him a lot. Here's his phone number, 240-516-4967. He's in the Prince George's County surrounding area, 240-516-4967. Now, if you want to call me, we still have a little bit of time together. We're talking about the wisdom of the purge. Who or what do you need to purge? What are you holding on to that you need to let go of? I'm going to Silver Spring, Maryland, as promised. I'm talking to Lisa, who's on the line. Hello, Miss Lisa. It's Dr. Anderson. How are you doing?
I'm well, thank you. Good afternoon, Dr. Anderson.
Good afternoon.
So I am hoping that you can give me a little bit of insight. I have been in a relationship longer than I should have, and I have prayed several times, like, Lord, please get this man out of my life, and I'll get a reprieve for, you know, a couple of weeks or a month. And I realized, I'm like, the only thing I can do is just pack up my bags and move, leave the state. But I just, I'm just trying to understand why God allows him to continue to stay. And I know that it's me, but at the same time, when I'm strong enough to say, please leave, that individual says, no, you're my destiny. And I'm like, no, God is my destiny, not you.
So let me just press in a little bit, Miss Lisa. Are you giving him mixed signals? Are y'all hanging out and doing romantic things, and then you feel guilty about it, and so you want him out your life? Or is it something different than that? Okay, I know the answer then.
Here's the thing. I will go quiet, and I'll just go radio silent for a while, because there'll be something that triggers me, and I'm just like, this is not working. This is not making me happy, and I need more in my life at this stage. And so I'll just go quiet, and he'll just let me go quiet. And then he's like, okay, are you done yet? And I'm like, no, can't you just leave me alone? And he's still like, well, no, I can't. And I'm like, oh Lord.
And he keeps winning you over. What is it about him that keeps winning you over?
You know, here's the thing. We can all say, you know, it's the comfort level and complacency that I have. But the other thing is, you know, because I've known him for a long time, so I know what to expect. But, you know, he's a confident person. So I like confidence, but I guess the confidence is overruling everything else. But I know that it's blocking me from other blessings and other opportunities.
You like the dude, but you know he's not the dude for you. And you want God to do the work. You want God to be like, just oops, he got moved to Texas. I mean, you know, and you'd be like, well, praise the Lord. You know, you want God to do the work. I bet you have. So you don't have to do the hard work, because the hard work is you say goodbye, and then you not only go radio silent, but you're really serious about it, and you're moving on with your life, and you can't seem to do that because you want a break, but then you start feeling lonely. And like, well, you know, he is kind of nice. And before you know it, y'all kicking it again. Am I right or wrong?
You're right. But here's the thing. I feel like I can keep going.
Well, why don't you do it?
I know. Okay. All right. But why does God keep? Okay. So it's me not being strong enough. But God is
not doing nothing. I mean, what I mean by that is, it's not like God, God is not, you know, he's giving you the strength to do it. You just got to make the decision and keep moving. But every time he comes around, you're thinking, oh, well, this must be God. He calling me, asking me if I'm doing all right. Well, let's go out to dinner. So, I mean, you're saying that there's something you don't want, then you're saying that there's something you want. So you're contradicting yourself because of what you really want.
Yes.
And what you really want is both and. You want to be able to kick it with him when you want to, without the drama of whenever you're upset. And then you want God to come in and do it for you. So you've really got to make a decision, because, you know, hey, once you make the decision and you're serious about it, I don't think it's going to be a problem. I think it's just that you're not serious about it yet. In my opinion, I could be wrong. Guys are persuasive. right? And you know, as long as they believe that there's still hope, they're gonna keep coming at you. Until they realize there's no hope, then they're gonna move on. But here's the problem: he's gonna move on to Sally, and then you know you can't be texting him talking about, you know, hey, I heard you going out with Sally. You want to get together?
Okay,
you
want to
get
that.
Together for some tea?
I'm okay with that. All right. Really want him to just keep going. I do.
Okay.
But okay, I get it. I gotta put my big girl pants on and do it.
Uh-huh, there you go.
Well, stick with it.
You did call me. It is called Real Talk. So I hope my opinion didn't offend you at all.
It is. I just wanted you to tell me, you know, God said.
Right. Exactly. Exactly. But I can't do that without getting in trouble with the Lord. So unless he really, really says it, you know,
I
think what he's telling me is it's time for you to go ahead and really stick with what you say or stop saying it. That's my thing. It's nothing bad with you staying with this dude or hanging out with him. I don't know if there's anything bad with that because I don't know him. He's probably a good guy. You know, and maybe y'all have some issues here or there, but you may not need to purge him. You know, I just don't know. But you can't keep saying you need to purge him and then you don't, you know. So stick with what you really, really want. But think about what Lisa really wants. Instead of saying what you think you want, say it. Think about it real good.
Nope, I got it.
You got it?
I will.
All
yes, righty. I do. I appreciate your time. Thank you.
Thanks for hanging with me. So glad you called. That's Lisa from Silver Spring. I'm proud of her for making that phone call. I know it's not easy. And we all contradict ourselves, don't we? Like, we say we want to lose weight, but then we say it while we're eating ice cream. I mean, seriously, you know, we get it. There's contradictions all over. But there comes a time when you do make a decision and you realize that, no, seriously, this is what I want. And then all of the ice cream and chips are out of the house and you're going to the gym regularly. That's when you know you really are not just talking. Otherwise, you're just talking, you know, and people talk all the time. So, and there's nothing wrong with it, you know, just realize you're just talking, all right? But if you really are making a decision, then go ahead and make it. And they're not always easy. And it comes with pain. It comes with grief. It comes with loss. But make that decision and then move forward in the way that you believe you're supposed to be going. 888-432-7434 is the number here in the studio. It's Wisdom Wednesday. We've been talking about what and who you need to purge and what is holding you back that you need to let go of. And, you know, the scriptures tell us that we can move forward, but sometimes it means you got to forget the past or put things behind you. In fact, the Apostle Paul said, brothers and sisters, I do not consider myself to have taken hold of it, but one thing I do, forgetting what is behind and straining toward what is ahead, I press on toward the goal to win the prize for which God has called me heavenward in Christ Jesus. I press on toward. Sometimes you got to press on and move forward, but that means that there's something probably behind you. It doesn't mean that you're not going to grieve it, but you got to leave it. 888-43-BRIDGE.
Believe in you, with the God of miracles. Hello, friends. This is Janice Fonseca, producer of Real Talk with Dr. David Anderson. I want to thank you for joining us on this thought-provoking radio show where Dr. Anderson creates a safe, uncommon table to build bridges where there's a divide. Because like he says, comprehension begins with conversation. Real Talk with Dr. David Anderson is a nonprofit ministry, and it is made possible with generous listeners like you. Will you consider partnering with us? It's really easy. Let me tell you how. Go to andersonspeaks.com and click on the donate button. Consider giving a monthly donation. If you're a business and want to sponsor Real Talk with Dr. David Anderson, email me at info@andersonspeaks.com. Together we can build bridges and have great conversations on Real Talk with Dr. David Anderson. Become a partner or a sponsor and go to andersonspeaks.com and donate. Join us again tomorrow at 3 p.m. and Saturday at 7 p.m. We want you to be part of this conversation. We can't do this without you. We look forward to your partnership and sponsorship. AndersonSpeaks.com.
And thank you so very much for your support. Also, thank you for supporting my sponsors, Maria Weaver, who is that real estate agent in Maryland. I have a better number for you. You had the other number, but let me give you a better number. It'll hit her directly instead of going through the office and being forwarded. How about that? You like that? You want it direct? Here it is. 410-258-0604. That's Maria Weaver, the best real estate agent in Maryland. 410-258-0604. Thank you so much for hanging out with me today on Real Talk with Dr. David Anderson. Think about what to purge if you need to purge, and the fact that God is doing a new thing. Remember, when you try to go to new levels, sometimes you got to fight new devils, but God is there with you. He'll give you the strength that you need. It starts with the decision that you make. And guess what? It's okay to be honest if you're not ready to make those decisions, you know, and that's the thing. Just be honest with yourself, be honest with the Lord, and ask him for the grace that you need in order to get to the next destination. Listen, tomorrow is going to be Theological Thursday, and then we'll have open phone in Friday. So I sure hope that you'll tune in to WAVA, which is the station that I'm on. And I'll see y'all on Facebook and on YouTube Live as well. Let's listen to that song that we like to hear. I'm going to give you a little couple extra seconds with it as we land the plane of the show with this prayer. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for being with us just as we asked at the beginning. And we pray that you would give us the wisdom necessary to know what to let go and what to hold on to. For it is in the name of Jesus we pray. Together, everyone said, amen and amen.
Father, help your children. Walk on through temptation, 'cause he's